Excellent. Welcome. All right. So starting off, as always, we'll open our Wirakocha, this eighth chakra around us, open this sacred space all around us so we can enjoy the peace and tranquility of being inside. So we'll bring our hands through to our heart, bring them up into this eighth chakra, this energy field, and then spreading it out all around us like a cocoon. Also goes underneath us as well. That's good. Good. And now we'll bring our hands together and we'll open up over the class. Those that are here and those that are watching the recording as well. That's good. I'm just bathing in the sacred space and this tranquility and peacefulness. That's good. And when you're ready, we'll pick up the fire stick, our death arrow. Any of those negativities or feelings or emotions you've felt today, just blow them into here and then we'll put them to the fire to release them. So anyone who's made you upset or angry or anything to do with scarcity or health, just blow them into the stick and we'll put them to the fire. So in your own time, just think of the thoughts and then we'll blow them in. Close, just turn it up and we'll back burn on yourself. That's good, in your own time. Like to hold on to your crystals, have them in your hands, the left hand with a single termination. If you have these crystals facing in and the right hand facing out, or however you like to hold your crystals, is good. And so when you're ready, just closing your eyes, listening to my voice. Relaxing. Any of those inside or outside noises or sounds that you hear, allowing you to go into deeper levels of relaxation. Anytime you want to change position, please do, making yourself comfortable. Relaxing there, I'd like you to picture, visualize, imagine relaxation coming down your body from the top of your head, starting at the top of your head, going into your forehead, your eyes, nose, cheeks, around your mouth and jaw and chin, relaxing. And now down the back of your head, allow the relaxation to come down to your neck. Neck into your shoulders. Shoulders down your arms, down to your elbows. Elbows into your wrists. Into your hands, out the ends of your fingertips. Now allow and bring that relaxation down the front of your body, down your chest and into your abdomen. Relaxing, letting go. Now allow that relaxation down your back, from your upper back, down to your middle back, lower back. Relaxing more and more. Now allow that relaxation into your hips. Hips into your legs. Front of your thighs, back of your thighs, relax. Knees down to your ankles. Ankles into your feet. Letting go. And if you're working with the crystals in your hands, picture, visualize, imagine that energy coming in through your left hand, up your arm and working its way in and around your body, cleaning, cleansing, energizing, and then coming down your right arm, and out the end of your fingers. So allow that now. Picture, visualize, imagine that there now. Letting go. Relax. Now start the breathing with counts of two. Breathing in for two, hold for two, out for two, hold for two. And we'll start to bring in the drum just to help with the rhythm and the beat and the vibrations as they work with you for your own self-healing. As the crystals are healing, the drums amplify that as well. Anytime you feel a little bit sunny or not sure, put the crystals down, bring the hands across your chest, bring yourself back to full awareness. Here we go. Breathing in. One, two, hold. One, two, out. One, two, hold. One, two, breathing in. One, two, hold. Out. Hold. In. Hold. Out. One more. In. 2, 3, 4. Out. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4. In. this relaxation more and more. That's good. The guided meditation this evening is on forgiveness. Wonderful to allow ourselves the relaxation that's needed in order for us to change things in our life that we desire and complete. Relaxation is impossible when we hold grudges. Sometimes it's hard to even imagine forgiving those who have wronged you. But this is a necessary step in the progression of personal achievement. So let's begin by saying, I'm ready to take the steps necessary towards becoming the best version of myself. It may seem daunting to forgive people and instances of your past that hurt you, but actually it can be very easy. Imagine a young child holding a glass of milk. Their hands couldn't quite grasp the cup fully, and the milk spills on the floor, breaking the glass. This upsets you because the milk is expensive, a cup was a family heirloom. So that this upsets you very much, and you show your anger and you hold a small grudge against this child for breaking the glass. Now, when you give that child a glass of milk, you will not trust him to hold it. And anxiety will become present in the child because they do not feel trusted. And anxiety will also build in you because you fear more things will be broken or spilled. Then, the child may actually become more likely to drop them because that is the image you are manifesting for them. You also have anxiety. You are unable to let go of this incident. It will be a recurring thought each time they need to use a cup. Now imagine again that small child holding a glass of milk. Their small hands quiver and they drop the cup, breaking it, spilling the milk everywhere. But this time instead, you are not upset in the slightest and you forgive them. The child runs to grab a broom and a towel to clean up the mess. They are helping to fix the mishap. They sense a new kindness. And they learn how to take action when something goes wrong. When they feel guilty for the circumstances, their ability to help is halted. The child is then likely to understand how to address incoming issues because everyone was calm, relaxed, and in a state of pre-forgiveness. They feel trusted and they can trust you to help when mistakes happen. That's what we need to accomplish in order to create a more peaceful world for everyone. The ability to pre-forgive each other, to allow for a state of openness, so that we can address issues that arise with calm and relaxed outlook, thus aiding in a thorough repair and the ability to move forward and trust others. Now, let's do some relaxation techniques that will open us into a state of forgiveness. Notice how your body feels right now. Notice any places that feel pleasant. It could be as small as the tip of your nose or a much larger area. Just feel these sensations of goodness and allow for them to expand. Perhaps these areas of nice sensations can communicate with those places in your body that feel stuck. Just observe how your body reacts when you allow pleasant feelings to communicate with stuck ones. Do the nice sensations hold a grudge against the areas of not so nice sensations? No. They simply hold space and communicate with openness how to let go. Allow for more pleasant feelings to enter into your body now through the power of your breath. Breathe in easily and consciously, knowing that with each inhale, you oxygenate your system and send goodness through your entire body. And again, inhale goodness and exhale into an even more relaxed state. Inhale supportive sensations and exhale into relaxation. Inhale deeply the force of good and exhale into relaxation. Continue this breathing now for 4 or 5 more good breaths. Breathing in this goodness, exhaling into relaxation. See how easy this is coming to you. You are natural at communicating with areas of tension, thus changing their very structure and frequency and converting them into a relaxed state. You're doing so very, very well. Let's continue with our newfound relaxed state to a place of forgiveness. This is a very important opportunity. It will aid you in progressing towards personal achievement in all aspects of your life. So I can visualize you in a beautiful garden on a mild day with fluffy clouds rolling by in the sky and the sun periodically warming your skin nourishing the plant in this garden. As you admire the beauty here, the way the leaves of the vegetation are caressed by the wind, there are many colours of flowers throughout the garden, and their fragrance is sweet and welcoming. You look down to see a small footpath through some flowering shrubs. And it's an inviting and mysterious path. So go down this way. As you curve around the beauty of this garden, you inhale the fresh oxygen that these plants produce. You feel very pleasant and relaxed. As you round a corner, a small bench made of wood comes into view, and you see the person you most need to forgive is sitting there. They have been waiting for you because this is a very important encounter. You sit down beside them because this place is very safe and there are some things that need to be said to this person. With bravery and courage, look them directly into their eyes and say, "You hurt me and I have suffered for too long because of this burden I carry in the form of a grudge towards you. I forgive you. I forgive you not to help you but to better myself. I forgive you and you will not enter my thoughts any longer. I forgive you because forgiveness leads to openness in all aspects of my life." You notice the darkness that was once in their eyes begins to lighten, and for a while they do not say a word. Then the silence is broken. They say simply to you, "I will leave you alone now, and you will not be tormented by the thought of me anymore." They get up from the beautiful wooden bench, walk into the depths of a nearby wooded forest. You watch as their figure grows smaller into the distance until you no longer see them. Never once do they turn and look back your way. Good. Very good. This was a very important meeting today in this beautiful garden. And as you breathe in new fresh air, you feel twice as light as you did before. That's because a huge weight has been lifted now that the person you needed to forgive is no longer sitting within your secret garden. They have moved on, and so have you. And as you are in this meditation, a meditative state, you notice you are eager and ready to take steps needed towards your own personal achievement, your own personal growth. Belief in yourself, everything that you do. Now enjoying this energy of the crystals as it works in and through your body. The sound of my voice allowing you to enjoy this relaxation even more. And as you relax relaxing there now, I'd like you to picture, visualize, imagine a light. A light coming out from the top of your head. Coming out from the top of your head and going all around your body. This light is any color of the rainbow. Could be a bright color or a softer color. Encompasses your whole body like a cocoon. And this light is full of love, peace, healing, protection, light. And expanding that light now from your head and around you, around this room and your room. Coming up on the top of your head, this color, this light, this peace, love, light, healing and protection. And now around the buildings, expanding out like sound waves moving out and across. And then out and around the neighborhood. Then the village or town or city, sharing this peace, love, light, healing and protection. And now taking this out further around your nation, your country. Sound waves moving up, this color of your choice coming up from your head, sharing this peace, this love, this light, this healing, this protection. Now to neighboring countries. And now it goes all the way around the world, around Pachamama, Gaia, around Mother Earth, this peace. Love, light, healing and protection. And I'd like you to send extra energy to areas of conflict around the world. The ones that we know about, the ones we don't know about. Where there's conflict going on, sending this extra energy of peace, of love, light, of healing and protection. From you, coming from the top of your head, giving out this light. And then from around Pachamama, going out into the universe, out as far as it will go. Love, light, healing and protection. It feels good. Bring yourself back to your awareness of your breathing. The breath and mindfulness of you being in this peaceful, relaxed state of meditation, allowing the self-healing to be a part of you and who you are. Thank you. weeks and months. And when you're feeling like it's feeling for it, you're able to write them down, journal them. Relaxation of those crystals, working their energy, peaceful and relaxed. That's good. Those inside or outside noises or sounds that you hear allow you to go into deeper levels of relaxation. Anytime you're feeling nervous and stressed or upset, you know, we take a few deep breaths, having this feeling that you have in your mind and body at the moment to bring it back. Allowing you to relax. Taking time to be in Mother Nature this weekend. But as we work in the forest, walk in the forest, on the beach, moment now, I'll count from 1 to 5. When I reach the count of number 5 or number 4, I'll say the word up. Be fully aware, feeling calm and rested, refreshed, relaxed, feeling wonderfully good. Wonderfully. 1. Slowly, calmly, easily inject the return to your full awareness once again. To every muscle, nerve, fiber in your body be loose, limp, relaxed, you're feeling wonderfully good. 3, from head to toe, you'll be feeling perfect in every way. Physically perfect, mentally perfect, emotionally calm and serene. 4, your eyes will feel sparkling, clear as a bathe in a cool spring mountain stream. In your own time at the next number, now be fully aware. You'll be feeling calm, rested, refreshed, relaxed, feeling wonderfully good. Wonderfully. Number 5, up, take a deep breath. Fill up your lungs, stretch. Slowly open your eyes. Bring up the forms of the world coach around the class, around you, and then bring it up into your eighth chakra. And then that energy just only for your highest good, bring it down and through your body. And then that little bit extra for Pachamama, Mother Earth, for how much needed healing. And then your own fold of your own world coach, bringing it up to this eighth energy center. And again, only for your highest good, bringing it down into your own chakras. And again, a little bit extra of Pachamama. Namaste. Oh.